Hey guys, welcome back to another video, and today I will be unboxing another amazing monitor from the AOC from their Aegon Pro series, and this one is AG276QZD. And the special thing about this monitor, this is from the very new series, and this one have the OLED display. So let's unbox this and see what do we have inside this box. Alright, so first thing first, just very careful with all these instructions. Please don't poke your screen like that and follow the instructions when you are taking out the monitor from your box. There we go. Okay, so first of all, we have the box where we will have all the accessories inside. So let me open this for you guys. All right, so this one, of course, have your power cable here. Then what else do we have? We have the power brick as well for this one. Then we have 1-inch HDMI cable, 1-inch display cable, and 1-inch USB Type-B cable, which always comes with all these Pro Series monitors. And then we have the screwdriver this time and have some screws. Of course, your manual, your quick start guide, everything you need to know about this product is everything is inside. That's all about it. So let's put everything on the side and open the set of the monitor itself. Okay, so this one is different than your normal regular AOC monitors because it's a totally new model. So what is this? I never seen in the AOC monitors before. So we will check this out. Then of course we have the base for it. Ooh, this time it's not plastic, it's metal base. Very nice. Though it's metal, but it's still very light. And then we have the arm itself. And there we go. Oh, totally new arm this time. So of course we have to figure this out, how we're gonna install all these. Oh wow, oh my goodness, check out the new monitor style. What we need to do is very straightforward. This should go here. Oh yeah, you can hear the click, right? Arm goes in automatically, and then we have the base. Oh, the style is really very different for this one. So there's a screw here at the back, so you can just tighten the screw. Okay, once you are done, just make sure it's secure and it's good to go, and you just pick up the monitor just like that. This one I was reading about, it is the wall bracket, so you can connect it or mount to the wall as well. So that's this one for. But what I'm talking about is this. Look at this beauty here. First of all, a very sexy slim bezel. And check out the back. The back have a lot of design element going on, which is the asymmetrical, and it looks super sexy. Imagine if this turns on, all the lights goes at the back, is gonna look super great. Check this out, it's so cool. It moves so nicely, and it can go portrait as well. Let's check out the front. How sexy is this? What else you want? So I think this will be my favorite AOC monitor, and it's going straight on my desk after this. So let's set this up. I'll show you guys how it looks, and then we will talk about all the amazing specs and features of this crazy monitor. Alright guys, so this one is all set up and it looks amazing. As you guys can see at the back, the RGB looks amazing. And then also I have connected my keyboard and mouse with the USBs here under the USB hub here. So that's also a very good feature. You don't have to connect to your PCs and all. So let's move towards the menu of this, and I'll talk a little bit about all the functions inside. So at the back of this monitor, there's this joystick which you can use. There are some hotkeys which are been set up already. So for example, if I bring it down, you can see there's a crosshair comes in, and if I press one more time it becomes red, and then also you can totally turn it off. Then if you move it to the left side, you have a different game modes. There are a few game modes inside. For example, at this moment it's totally off. Then we have the FPS mode, we have the RTS, we have the racing, gamer 1 custom, gamer 2 and gamer 3. All these three are the custom modes as well. Then let's keep it on the gamer 3 mode, and then after this when you move it up, you can see all the display sources here, which is the DP1, DP2, HDMI 1 and 2. You can choose from here. We are on the DP1, so we'll just press that one. Okay, so if we go into the menu of this, so where we can see the game setting, which we talked about earlier about the gamer mode. So there you can adjust all the further settings from it. And then after that, we have the luminance here. You can check your contrast, brightness, and you can turn on and off your HDR modes, which is the movie, game and different modes available for you guys here. So the next one is the picture in picture settings, where we have the two options, which is the picture in picture and picture by picture. Press this picture in picture, it will turn the whole screen into a picture in picture mode, where this is, for example, my laptop I'm using or other PC, it will be showing here and rest of the screen here. And then if I move here to the picture by picture mode, which is the this mode, it will change or split into two settings here, which is the half of the PC and half of the second PC or any other source which are coming. Actually, it looks like this. So half of this part and half of this part. So depends on which source you want to use this. Okay, here if I go back, then we can actually, if you turn this on, for example, then later on we can actually check the source, which main source you want or sub source you want for this menu as well. Then after that, we have the color setup. In the color setup, of course, you can turn on and off for the blue light mode, and then you have a lot of other features to play around here. After that, we have audio, because this one comes with the speaker itself, so the speakers is also quite decent on this monitor, so you can utilize that and arrange the settings or volume of the speakers from here. Let's go back. The next is the, of course, light effects, which is all your lights at the back of this, how you want to control that RGB. It looks amazing. My favorite is the strong breathing and the rainbow pattern. So I love this one, I'll keep it as it is, but it depends on you which one you want. Then we have some extras here. In the extra, of course, your input select, so I left it on auto, your USB hub and all the other information available for you guys also. So actually there are a lot of options, you can go through these or you can check on their website what all this option does as well, but here most important is the resolution and frequency are shown here. Then after this, we have the OSD setup. In the of course here we can choose the language, we have timeout, and we can set up H position, V positions, transparency, and also the break timers. You can turn it on and off. If you are playing a lot or working a lot, you can set up these timers as well. So guys, that was all about the menu of this. So let's move towards the specs and features of this amazing product. Alright, so this monitor comes with the 2 into HDMI 2.0 ports, 2 display ports, which is 1.4, 3.5mm headphone jack, and 2 into USB-A ports, and 1 into USB-B upstream port, plus the power port. The stand height is 130mm, rotation is minus 45 degrees to 45 degrees, and for the swivel is minus 15 degrees to 15 degrees, and the tilt minus 3 to 21 degrees, and the VESA mount is 100mm by 100mm. As well. Aegon by AOC started to use OLED panels more and more in their gaming monitors, and the AG276QZD is no different. The technology of OLED panels gives a big advantage in both picture quality and smoothness. This monitor has a resolution of 2560 by 1440 with a wing angle of 178 degree by 178 degree. 27 inch monitor with a fast 240Hz refresh rate and a crazy 0.01 millisecond G2G response time, providing you with a fast and smooth gaming experience. The visuals that this OLED panel provides is just as amazing as its performance. It has a color gamut of 100% sRGB and 98.5% DCI-P3, with a bit depth of 10 bit and around 1.07 billion colors. It also has a contrast ratio of 150,000:1, but it can go all the way to 1,500,000:1 if you enable dynamic contrast ratio. Finally, it has the HDR10 support that enhances the highlights and shadows to give you the best visual experience. This monitor has two built-in 5-watt speakers, so you can also get clear and rich audio from this monitor. To further support the performance, this monitor is G-Sync compatible, which matches the monitor's refresh rate to the GPU frame rate to remove issues like screen tearing and stuttering. Alright guys, I hope I have covered all the amazing features of this amazing monitor. If you guys want to know more about this product, I will be dropping the link in the description of this video. You guys can check out on their website, or if you have any question, just let me know in the comment section. I'll be happy to reply you guys. And if you guys have enjoyed the video, don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Until then, take care and bye bye.